Are you a tea cake lover? Without any doubt, me and my family are a big time lovers of simple and delicious tea cakes. This cake is intense, smells divine, and when eaten, glides in your mouth like a butter. Hi guys, welcome to Vidya Cooking Diary. Today I am going to show you the best ever authentic Parsi style eggless mawa cake, and I am sure that you are going to love it. So without wasting any time, let's directly dive into making it. So let's start with our dry ingredients, for which I have taken a bowl in which I will be adding about 3/4 cup of all purpose flour or maida, about 1/2 teaspoon of baking powder and 1/4 teaspoon of baking soda and a pinch of table salt. Now using this whisk, I will gently mix all the dry ingredients and let's keep it aside. Now using another bowl, let's make the wet ingredients, for which I have taken about 1/4 cup of soft butter. If in case your butter is lying in the fridge, make sure that you take it out at least 45 minutes before making this cake. Now to this I'll be adding powdered sugar. Here I've taken 1/2 cup plus 2 tablespoons of powdered sugar. Using my silicone spatula, I will be mixing up the butter and the powdered sugar together. This process is called creaming. This wouldn't take a lot of time, just 1.5 minutes or so. So you can do it with the spatula, no need of a hand mixer in this case. This is already creamy and fluffy. It's all ready. The powdered sugar which I've used is, I have converted the granulated sugar in the help of a mixer and I've converted it into a powdered sugar. Okay, now let's add all the remaining ingredients. Firstly, 1 teaspoon of cardamom powder, about 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract. Now I'll be adding about 1/4 cup of curd. Here I have used the homemade curd. You can also use a store-bought one. Now let's give it a good mix. At this stage, the batter would look as if it has curdled up. Please do not worry. This is how it's always. I've tried this recipe many times and every time it turns out this way. But it's absolutely fine. Now let's add about 1/2 cup of khoya, also called as mawa, the main ingredient of this recipe. I have used the store-bought mawa today. You can also prepare it at home. If you want to know how to prepare it, do let me know. I shall show it in another video. Now breaking the lump, I shall be mixing the mawa with the cake batter. You can even grate the mawa and add instead of adding the way I have done. But both would take equal time, so I prefer breaking it like this. Now let's add the milk. Here I have added about 1/4 cup plus 3 tablespoons of milk. Let's give it a gentle mix. And our wet ingredients are all ready. Now let's start adding the dry ingredients. Don't add it directly, because remember, this being an eggless cake, we need to sift it to make the cake really fluffy and soft. So with the help of a sieve, I'm going to sift it. See, can you notice the lumps now? This is the reason why we really need to sift the dry ingredients. Now using the cut and fold method, let's bring the batter together. Please do not over mix at this stage. Just mix it as much as required. This wouldn't take much time, just about a minute or so. This is a very easy cake, guys. You should definitely give it a try. I have already preheated my oven at 180 degrees Celsius for about 10 minutes. The batter looks perfect to me. The consistency is absolutely right. So it's just falling right off my silicone spatula. That means the batter is perfect. It shouldn't be runny. Today I'm using a square cake tin. You can use round or any other form of tin. So let's transfer the batter to the cake tin. The batter itself is smelling amazing. Now let's slowly spread across the batter with the help of the spatula. Having an spatula like this makes preparation of the cake really easy. So if you are a regular baker, do consider investing in on a good spatula. Now let's add a handful of chopped almonds and cashews. Traditionally, the mawa cake was decorated with the cashews and almonds. So I am keeping it authentic and I'm going to decorate my cake with the almonds and cashews. So it's all ready. Let's give it a good tap. And let's place it in the oven and bake it for about 40 minutes. So the mawa cake is ready. It's out of the oven and perfectly cooked. Look at the color, guys, the golden hue, and my entire house is smelling so divine. Now I'm running a knife across the tin and the cake just to make sure that the cake is not sticking to the tin anywhere. If you're new to my channel, welcome. And if you like this video, do like, share and subscribe to my YouTube channel. This cake can also be baked in a kadai. I have used a broad base aluminium kadai which I had preheated for 10 minutes. And then cook the cake for about 35 minutes in the low flame. Now let's get rid of the parchment paper. I can't tell you guys how amazing this cake is smelling. Everybody in the house are just waiting to dig into it. Look at it, guys, so good. You guys should definitely try making this cake and let me know how did it turn out. This is the cake which I had baked in the aluminium kadai. It's looking amazing, guys. The round cakes have a different appeal of itself, right? I hope you like this recipe. Thank you for watching.